SM500 today, right above Ducktown. Just got into the Cherokee National Forest. So a little solo ride today on a beautiful Saturday. And just thought I'd take a quick little video. This is a pretty cool little area. I've been riding for a little bit, but mostly highway through the town and everything. But starting to get kind of nice, starting to get fall of the year. Sort of glad to be on the trail. Been a little under the weather all week, so got to feeling better. Thought we'd get out here. My riding buddy Cody's, I think he's under the weather too. I think the weather changed here where we're at. It's just kind of got everybody crudded up. So I'm feeling better today. Thought we'd get out here on the trail. Ride a little bit on the DR350. So enjoy, guys. We'll come back at you after a while, do a little ride, try to film some highlights. I think the goal today is maybe to try to ride up maybe 40 or 50 miles or so on the north, and then pick a route on the way back. Just maybe a little bit 50-50 or so. There's a little gold mining area that I kind of been wanting to see for a long time. Cooper Flats, I believe that's what it is. Or maybe I'm wrong about that, but anyway, we'll be back at you soon. Just riding in this little open valley, guys. Thought I'd turn the camera on. It's getting kind of pretty up in here. Whoa, watch out for sticks. But I would probably bet a paycheck down in that valley is a creek or a river. We're still just about 10 miles above Ducktown, Tennessee. Been coming into some pretty big water holes, but so far they've had pretty hard bottom, so that's what we'll hope for, right? I see some bike tracks through there, so that helps me decide to trudge forward. This has been some pretty good riding. Just been 10 miles, like I said, but pretty good riding so far. I don't really know what it is about the human nature that, yeah, that's really pretty. Man, we're starting to get up on top of the mountain now. Looks really nice. It's like maybe some of these trees have died here. Yeah, what I was saying is I'm not real sure what it is about human nature that makes us want to find out what's around this next bend up here, across the creek, or on the other side of the river, over the hill, but something drives us forward to do it. Work all week and look forward to seeing what's around the next corner when we get on the trail. It's just a great thing about adventure. Guys riding, that's good to know. Sure, what kind of bike that was. Yeah, I figured I might see some bikes out this weekend. Oh boy. Oh boy. Let's assess this. Okay, appears like everybody's been going around it right here. Might be the thing to do. Might be the thing to do. I wasn't really expecting that today, solo. But we'll make it happen. Pretty big rocks in here. Wow. There we go. Maybe there won't be too many more of them obstacles. Makes it interesting, but make you work a little bit too. It makes me think not too many people's come this way, but of course, I guess if there's a decent, easy way around something, then nobody's got a saw with them. I should mark that probably. You know what? Let's do that. Let's put a pin, and that way we can let people know there's a tree down right there. Let's back up just a little. How's it going? Yeah, man, there's a big tree across. Have you guys been through it lately? I'm marking it here so I can share it. Oh, okay. How y'all getting along?
Oh, we're doing good.
You guys will be all right. It's a little hairy. You got to go around it to the right. But it's not bad, though.
Yeah,
it's
these things are tanks.
Coming from the other way was... Yeah. A little steep, but going back this way be fine. I was kind of like, I'm by myself, you know, I'm like, and I've met four or five other bikes. I'm like, well, they went around. Well, I'll let you men ride. Y'all got a little ride if you're going to Suches.
Thanks so much.
But check that out. That Lake Conasauga, when you see that sign, it's not far. It's worth just to roll through the campground, take you some pictures by the lake with your bike.
Awesome.
It's good meeting you guys. Be safe. You want me to come up here and make sure y'all get over that? Okay, it's just right there. I'll make sure. Yeah, it's always nice to walk it first. Bed down here. chilly. Fuel right there. Pretty cool gas station. Don't think I've ever been across this bridge. About Gaia, hope you can see this. So if you pay for the service, it's $10 a year, I think, if you find it on sale. And there is a layer, so basically paying for the service gives you extra layers. And layers, you know, are topo and satellite, things like that. But there's a layer on here that's called Mines and Minerals. And place in Tennessee called Cooper Gap right here, and every one of those pickaxe crossings is a gold mine. Now they're probably ancient, but evidently at some point somebody found some gold in these parts right up in here, because there are tons of them. I'm gonna zoom out. You can see them all up and down in here. It's called Cooper Flats. But I thought I would just ease through here. I'm kind of headed back today, but I wanted to ride through here before I got back on the highway. So just like literally right off of the road right in here is going to be some gold mines, if you probably looked around hard enough, which is private property, so I wouldn't do that. But I guarantee you right off in those woods right over there, you can find an attic probably, which is, that's pretty cool. Way back in the day when they were digging in the ground for gold. But anyway, I just thought I'd show you guys that. Pretty cool feature for Gaia. It's worth it for me for $10 a year to find cool stuff like that. out, they took off. Man. Let's go down here just a little piece and see. Question. We'll leave them doggies alone. I thought I would show you guys those Pan Ams. There's six of them, and there's another couple of Harleys that they turned into dirt machines, like old Sportsters. Really cool. Those doggies didn't like it though. But we're headed south on 68. Out of Teleco Plains, headed back to Ducktown. I'm parked in Ducktown today, so good little ride through here. I'll let the camera roll some. Alright guys, I did a little video at the end of the ride today to tell you about where I parked and a little ending to the video, and it got cut off somehow. Sometimes the Hero 9 can get a little glitchy or something sometimes. But anyway, I just wanted to share that the truck has been super nice, because we're usually 100 miles or more from the trail. Like today it was 120 miles from my house to where we rode at, or I rode at. Man, something going down over here. Oh, it's a Jeep Jamboree. I'll show you guys. Little shit. Oh, it's Trunk or Treat with Jeeps. That's pretty cool. Anyway, I just got the bike loaded up on the back there, on my little carrier, as you can see maybe back there. But anyway, I decided to drive the truck because it's 100 miles, 120 miles to the trail. Sometimes you ride 100 miles or more, and then you gotta ride 100 miles home. And it's not so bad on a cruiser bike, but if you're on a dirt bike, it's rough. Even the best seat money can buy, it can get rough. So I thought, since I'm in the truck and I got it fresh on my mind, I'd just tell you guys about that. And I parked in a little town called Ducktown, Tennessee, we talked about earlier. And it's a really good gateway to a lot of dirt roads in the upper portion of Tennessee here, or not necessarily the upper portion, the southern portion, really, I guess. But anyway, that's all I wanted to let you guys know. I appreciate you riding along today. And leave me a like down there below, and comment. And if you think about it, if you want, leave us a subscription. Maybe YouTube will, you know, recommend a video to you next time if you do. And me and Cody gonna try to make a couple more videos before it gets too cold. Like the end of the day today, it was getting a little chilly. So we'll, I don't mind getting an electric jacket or something and keeping on trying to ride, but sometimes it can get kind of miserable around here. It's like a weird cold. It's almost like the air freezes or something. So anyway, guys, that's all I got today. I appreciate you guys watching for your support. And we'll get this up on there, and you let us know what you think about it. Appreciate it.